So Glaive is a new artist I've been checking out this year. My homie actually put me on to his music. He dropped the All Dogs Go to Heaven project back in August. I checked it out about a month later. After listening to just a couple songs, I was instantly a fan, and it opened me up to a new genre called hyperpop. Hyperpop is kind of what Trippie Redd did with Trip at Night, but that's more of rage beats slash like the term hyper trap is something that I've even used. It is a little bit of a different sound, but this genre is actually really fire. It came up sometime around last year. Throughout me listening to Glaive and actually going into his other project and some of his other singles out, figured out who Eric Doa is, Midwest. I've listened to a little bit of them, but back to All Dogs Go to Heaven. It's only 8 songs, but still to this day, it hits. So that's why I had the idea of making this review so late. The first video on the project is 1984, which has a Lyrical Lemonade video directed by the GOAT, Cole Bennett. And that being the first song, that actually leads me to the track-by-track review we're gonna do right now. This 1984 song is actually super upbeat, happy. Honestly, the song is easily one of his best. As I've learned, he's really, really good with his choruses. He makes every single song extremely catchy. Usually the songs in hyperpop, they just end up being around 2 minutes. They're so fast paced. It's just the style. And that's exactly what this is. This is kind of like the go-to formula hit-making song that Glaive makes. You really know that he's putting in effort. It's emotional. And the song is actually a banger. I actually guessed the Nick Mirror production. I was like, dude, why is this beat actually so good? It's like Nick Mirror or some shit. 2 seconds later, credits popped up. I guessed that shit. Detest Me is the second song, and this one has more of a buildup in it. Again, you get the vibe, the feel of the genre. Before it hits the chorus again, it pauses, and then the beat drops, so that part goes crazy. One thing I like about this song is it will be chill, and then out of nowhere, because, you know, everything is based around the production and everything, it just, boom, you're right back into the song. Tempo picks up. The beat just goes crazy. I don't even know the names of the instruments, but, like, shit starts going crazy. Track 3 is Poison. And honestly, this is my least favorite on the project. It's still a good song, but it's not a banger compared to the rest. I think, like, overall, I can't really remember the production as much on this one, or even, like, his performance on the song compared to my other favorites. Still a really solid song, you know what I'm saying? I'm not just gonna sit here and shit on it. Track 4, Stephanie. This one, banger alert, bro. It's similar to 1984, where, again, it's emotional but still upbeat. The song always kind of just makes you happy. Again, you get that hyperpop tempo in the song. Another just classic Glaive song right here. Track 5 is Synopsis. Travis Barker production. So that's how crazy this shit gets when you get the live drums from Travis Barker in your song. And again, bro, this song just hits, bro. Like, these, they just make you happy. You're just going crazy throughout the song. Number 6, I Wanna Slam My Head Against the Wall. Literally. And this one is actually kind of my real first taste of hyperpop and like how crazy it can get, because I was listening to like Midwest, and like his shit sounds a lot more like this, where it gets like a lot more electronic and like that type of shit, where it goes crazier. Because Glaive kept it tame, you know what I'm saying? Like, he was a lot more melodic on this. You know, you do get like some drums and some nice guitars on most of these beats. I feel like that's actually why I like this project so much, because this melodic stuff could be similar to Kid Laroi or Trippie or something like that. Not saying Glaive's exactly like them, but listening to melodic artists like that just helped me like Glaive more, probably. Actually, an underrated part is just the acoustic guitar coming in at the beginning. Track 7 is Bastard. And low-key, the beat is fruity. I'm hearing like a do-do-do-do-do in the back when the song's going crazy. Yeah, the last few songs are just a streak of hard-hitting cuts on this album. Just more of the louder songs, more of the bangers. And track 8, not a banger. Actually, it's really sad. It's All Dogs Go to Heaven, the title track, the outro. Yeah, it's sad, but, you know, he's spitting facts here. It is the truth. And just overall, it just completes the theme. It is the perfect outro song. When you have songs like this on your projects and in your discography, it doesn't make every single song sound the same, and your fans are gonna get bored because you kind of switched up a bit. So I really like how he closed up the project with All Dogs Go to Heaven. The ending song just captures everything that you just listened to. So he just did a really good job putting this project together. Like, Probably like 9.5 out of 10. We're gonna cover more hyperpop as I get more familiar with it. Glaive doesn't have a ton of misses. He's got a lot of enjoyable songs, and you know, I'm glad I'm a fan. So if you guys like my review, my name is Cole Frosty. Go ahead and subscribe for more hip hop content. I got a Twitter, go follow me there. And yeah, like, comment, subscribe, and peace.